What's going on? If you are new here, obviously go check out episode 1 that we reacted to in the last video. This is episode 2, and if you don't know, it is Burn the Witch movie time that has been split into 3 parts, which is has the runtime of 61 minutes, which is interesting because the theater version is 61 minutes while this version is 63, and I would imagine that's because it has an ending, which is the song that we heard in the PVs, which is beautiful, might I add. So if you want to see a reaction to that, hopefully it hasn't been copyright striked. If it has, then that sucks. However, yeah, go check that out, and I just really want to watch episode 2, so I'm gonna watch episode 2. So yeah, it is unedited over at Patreon if you want to go check it out, but for now you're gonna have an edited version of my face. So let's get into it, man, because I'm pumped. So yeah, I want to watch. Nah, Nini never denounced Macy. The media made it seem that way, so no different from the BBC normally anyway. This one's called Boot TV, so it's probably some, you know. Oh shoot, yo, that went right through the TV. Ellie, settle down. You got mad on my behalf. That's kind of mad, still. But yeah, like the media. Oh, she has got a chest, to be honest. Okay, right. It didn't. Gilisu, she makes me special. Yeah. Oh, so this is the 2 chapters. Yeah, chapter 2 and chapter 3. Let's go. I loved this scene. This scene was great. What bothers me, just like it did in chapter 1, is that they never really showcase them beating the first dragon. I assume that they did, because obviously Noelle is on the front cover, so. While you're reading the front London articles, see, this has changed too. And I think I prefer the manga version of this, to be honest. See him in different outfits and whatnot, instead of in Billy Banks' office. Haha, this is back to canon. So they really just brushed over a few pages of manga there, which is a bit weird, to be honest. Again, it's not bad, I just prefer the manga version of that, because different scenery. Look at her face, she's pouting. He's always just so happy about everything. Just happens to like, bro, this man is like the typical guy, except he's the typical guy isn't always happy, but he has the mind of a guy. Look at Osushi, just like the disappointment on his face. Therefore, joke you right now, you'll probably die. He's like, that's fine. Seagulls, okay, that's based on reality a little bit with London. Oh yeah. Are we really getting into it that quick, huh? Was it always this quick? So our jurisdiction dealing with terrorists is the police's job. And this was... See, I wish they would have gone more into that, but like... If it's not a dragon, we'll probably get points for going. Yeah. Oh my god, just went upside down. It was like, fine. I'm too lazy for this. It's interesting though, because like, again, in the manga it kind of explains more about the difference between getting involved with front London's issues on the other side of London. So there's some good world building there. Huh? Bungee gun? Hunter Hunter reference. The art is really good. That's my line.
Why
Yo, that grew. That fucking grew. Oh shit, let's go! Ayo? Oh, Ellie got slapped. You hate to see it, honestly. Is this from her perspective? Yeah, it is. Yo, let's go! Oh shit. Yo, she's pissed. She's in love with me, you say. Oh, hell yeah. Apparently. Oh shit, an angry lesbian. Don't go to the roof. Don't go to the roof! Bang! Hey! Reno! Here's the fucking goat! Let's go! And that's the end of chapter 2. I suppose he did it in a really smart way of framing him. There'll be a bounty on his head. Whoever takes him out will go down in reverse on his history forever. That's why you want to get him first and then do it when the bounty. Okay. Makes sense. Oh, Noel looks pissed. Die job of Edison. Yeah! Yo! Go me. But I guess that's how you Pipers learn to operate. Are you the one that brought Mace to Reverse London? The dragon was already with her. So there is mana. It makes sense. It is magic. So then you've got a question. So they have mana. All of them have mana. Interesting. So the question is mana and Reishi the same thing? I would assume so, they just call it something different. Dual pistol, let's go! Yeah! And the episode's almost done, I believe, if it's following the manga correctly. Rickenbacker, let's go! Oh, there's Ellie just chilling there. It's time to move. Yeah! Most idols don't, surprisingly enough. There's gonna be some foreshadowing in here with Balgo. You'll see him soon. Are they gonna show it? No, they didn't. They didn't show Balgo. Why? That's the foreshadowing. Oh, that's kind of cute. And then it grew up kind of ugly. But she just kept getting bigger. Started looking more and more like a dragon. Bruh. This is good backstory, I would say. Probably Kubo that, like, gave him this backstory, because we know that he worked on the anime as well as the manga, so he probably delved a little bit deeper into these things, which is interesting. Because if you think about it, the manga was just like his own hobby, so he probably wasn't adding as much as he could have. Maybe, I don't know. Why am I put a wingbine thing on it? You wouldn't normally say. Yep, there we go. Just slapped through the barrier like it was butter. At least he gave him the opportunity. No! Oh, no! I love this ending. I know I'm going to edit this out, but I want to listen to the ending again because it's such a banger, bro. Another banger of an episode. I don't know what to say in these things. I'm just, like, really enjoying it. Like, if you expected to get a review after these episodes, like, you got me kidding because, like, I'm so enjoying this. Like, this is so, like, cool. They're, like, skimming through it a lot. They're really, like, going through the chapters, like, really quick, while at the same time adding a lot of, like, in-depth stuff to it. As I said throughout the live reaction, too, is that, like, yeah, like, Kubo did this in his own free time. It probably, to him, like, he probably wasn't going as deep as he probably could have, or probably wasn't thinking that it would be anything special because it would have been just for him. So to have, like, him working on the anime and giving, like, Meisu, like, this, even though it was, like, only a few minutes, just that's all it takes to just feel a little bit empathetic for the character. And that's probably something I will say in the review and lean upon more on. But as I said, like, it looked great. There's a few things of, like, why they've changed things from the anime compared to the manga, but nothing too much. There's nothing to really complain about, because it's all about the context of why they changed it and what the scene led up to. It just looked cool. Like, I honestly got no complaints. I don't know what to say. It's a live reaction, mate. Like, again, if you want the review, hopefully that these live reactions do well and you enjoy it, and I'll do an in-depth review. But I'm really excited to see how the last episode is going to pan out. Oh, God. Okay, so I'm going to catch you guys later. You guys, of course, have this fine day in hand. So please hit that like button and drop a comment in the comment section down below, because it helps with the algorithm. And of course, please, if you can, share this around. And if you want to see the unedited versions, please check out the Patreon and help support the channel. Other than that, I'm excited. So I'm going to catch you guys later. Peace out.